Now to a WPBF 25 News exclusive. It is one of the biggest crimes our area has ever seen. Nathaniel Brazill made national news back in 2000 after he shot and killed his middle school teacher in Lake Worth. And as we first reported yesterday, Brazill has reached out to us. Terry Parker is live in the studio with new details on his lawsuit against prison officials. Terry?
Tiffany, Nathaniel Brazill was just an eighth grader before he was convicted and sent to prison, but he's gotten a paralegal degree through a correspondence course and is writing what some judges and lawyers say are credible, well-reasoned lawsuits, including this new one claiming prison harassment and retaliation.
This is not the first time Nathaniel Brazill has filed his own lawsuit. In 2009, he appeared in court asking for a new trial, arguing a motion he wrote himself in jail. Judge John Castronakis denied the motion, but praised Brazil's legal chops. And his attorney, Greg Lerman, who argued the motion for Brazill, agrees.
Of the jailhouse lawyers, to use that term that I've met, he's probably one of the smartest individuals. You know, he could have went a long way had he taken a different fork in the road.
Brazill was only 13 when he made international news, convicted of shooting to death his Lake Worth teacher, Barry Gruneau. Now serving 28 years, in a letter Brazill wrote only to WPBF 25 News, he reveals he has filed a new lawsuit, claiming he has been the victim of sustained harassment and retaliation in prison. Brazill filed a civil rights lawsuit against three officials, including a former prison colonel, Beth Cowart, whom he says got angry when he filed an earlier lawsuit in 2009 complaining about conditions in prison. As evidence of the retaliation, Brazill says a prison librarian told him, quote, to watch himself because defendant Cowart was mad about the lawsuit and explained how defendant Cowart slammed a copy of the complaint on the desk. Brazill says Cowart ordered him into solitary confinement for 27 days and transferred him twice to other less desirable prisons.
It wouldn't shock me that he would put together a well-thought-out and well-reasoned and researched complaint, and if people are abusing his rights or others' rights, that he would stand up for those rights.
Lerman says inmates' lawsuits are usually taken more seriously in federal court, and that some have gone as far as the Supreme Court.
So maybe Nathaniel Brazill will be in front of the U.S. Supreme Court one day. Never know.
The federal judge in Brazil's case is taking it seriously, saying there wasn't enough evidence. He dismissed several defendants Brazill originally included in the lawsuit, but did not dismiss the complaint against the former colonel and two others, and in fact, denied those defendants' requests for a time extension in the case. Main defendant Beth Cowart told me she did not want to comment on the lawsuit, and we have not yet heard back from the Department of Corrections. Terry Parker, WPBF 25 News.